So, James, would you like to follow that?
I was just thinking the same thing.
Joe Pasquale's staying here as well. Now, James, I mean, it is quite something to come in and listen to somebody singing live like that. But also for all of us, it's quite something to have proper actors. And you are proper actor.
Am I?
Yeah, because I love that it says, I'm going to read this, and Joe is on your left so he could giggle. It says, James Barriscale, this is what it says in your press release.
Oh, yeah.
James Barriscale is no stranger to our screens, having played many popular primetime television shows. And you are, because you're one of those faces that you do see. You're on telly a lot. But now you're doing WPC 56, which is a really, I think it's called The Midwife, but an edgier.
Yes, it is, actually. And weirdly, I think now there is no daytime evening slot. There's just good shows. And whether that's on at 2 o'clock in the afternoon or, you know, any sort of Freeview channel, you can flick on CSI at 10 a.m. and The Sweeney at 7:30 in the morning. So I think things have changed a lot.
But people do get a bit sort of, I don't know, prissy about daytime. And I don't think I've made a career out of it.
Yeah, it's not the same as it has been, though. It's really changing. And they're just finding really good slots for really good shows. It's such a good show. I honestly... really gritty and challenging for the period of things they had to deal with then, with racism and sexism, and it's done beautifully as well. It looks fantastic.
Do you know what's so extraordinary, that Joe, what year were you born?
61.
You didn't 61. Okay, so it's only 5 years before you were born.
Yeah.
When you watch it,
yep.
It's history.
It is,
and it feels like such a long time ago because things were so different then.
Yeah.
And weirdly, they were still dealing with the same problems now, whether it's bent coppers or the mafia or homosexuality in the workplace, and dealing with that. Some things have changed, but other things haven't changed at all. It's really interesting.
I find it quite frightening, really, though, that some of those things still continue
exactly.
now.
Exactly. And they go through waves, don't they, of acceptance and then the result of what we're seeing now in various countries, So, yeah.
Well, so, tell us about your character. And for people who haven't seen, because there has been a series before, you weren't in the first series, so now series two is on, and it will be even better because you're in it.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true, son. About five or six new characters coming into it, which is really nice. It's gritty, but it also has a very nice side to it, and a very light side, a very kind side, which mainly comes from Sergeant Swift. And he looks after his new coppers. He tries to guide them into the right direction and do the right thing. He believes in a good copper, whether they're a woman or a bloke. And so he's a really good, solid character who, throughout the show, has to deal with a new staff member. In the guise of Susie Nightingale, brilliantly played by Rachel Leskovac. We have a bit of a will they, won't they thing going on. That's all I'm going to say. But it's beautifully written, and it was a real pleasure to do.
But also women being in a role like that in those days. Am I being very naive? Obviously, I wasn't in the police force in the 50s, but I presume that women had a very tough time. It was quite rare, wasn't it?
Yeah, absolutely right. And this is the first woman in that district as well, so it's even tougher for her. So it deals with that, but it also deals with what they ask her to do as well, how they send her out, how they put her in situations that are actually quite dangerous as well, which I don't think they would do so much nowadays.
Do you think also there was a different respect for police than nowadays? Because I think a lot, the case of the Plebgate row and all sorts of things, people's belief and, I don't know, sort of adoration or hero worship or whatever it was many years ago doesn't seem to be around now.
I absolutely agree. When you put on a costume and you're a policeman in a modern drama, you put it on and you feel different to when you put on a costume from the 1950s
really?
Police uniform. Yeah, because when you put on a 1950s police uniform, you feel what you were. You try and feel how they were in those days, and that is a figure of authority who was respected and feared, actually. Mm. There was an authority figure there with your dad or with a policeman or with anyone else who you feared.
I think that stays with you even now, though, even because I'm 52 now, and I was, scared stupid of coppers when I was a kid. And even now, you know, when you see in the wing mirror of a police car, there's a copper there. Whereas, my kids, they're like, that was a copper. What are you worried about?
Yeah.
You ain't done nothing. Funny, no, I haven't done nothing, but my whole being goes,
but do you think that comes down to respect?
I think it does. I think it was different 40 years ago. It was. Everything was different, and it was talking about my kids today. But I think with the police in particular, I think also just the costumes you said that you wear, but the uniforms they wear, it's more about protection there as well.
Yeah.
Rather than what
Absolutely.
It was then.
The helmets weren't very strong in those. They were made of cork. So
really? Were they?
Yeah. So I was putting these things on. We were putting on real helmets. Thinking, this isn't going to do much good.
Now, you're also known as a voice. You do many voices.
Yes, I do.
You do voiceovers of video games and things, don't you?
I do.
Could you do, please, now this is the thing, when you came in, so I'm going to get you to do something. Could you do video voice for us, please?
I can, but I have to cut the swearing out, because some
of
the video
games now. Yes, no swearing. We've already had Joe do that, it's fine.
I've done it, and we've loved it.
Damn, we got in there too early. No, a lot of them are hard characters, so one of them I played was called Bernard Lerido. And he had a whole dungeon of dwarfs that used to keep as slaves and lots of nasty things. Some of the video games are really quiet. But I've just done one recently, which is I can't say too much about because it's not been released yet. But it's a First World War game about the people in the war, not a war game. So it's actually dealing with letters that they found from real people, and they've integrated it with characters. And
that sounds more pleasant.
I was lucky enough to do some of the letters that they reconstructed and stuff on the game, which was beautiful and. You know, something worth doing as well.
No, because Joe, do you ever do voiceovers?
Do I? Really? Are you winding me up? Yeah. No, sometimes I go about on my bike and land in one studio to another. I love doing them because you get booked because it's not an audition for me now because they know what I sound like. You don't get booked because, can you do this? I remember a little while ago, I went in for one. I don't normally audition for voices now, but this one, they did it for a cartoon of a teddy bear. And they had me doing the whole thing. It was like three episodes, did the whole thing, 20-minute episodes. And at the end of it, I went, that's great. Could you do it in a deeper voice with a northern accent? And I went, no. He went, why not? I said, well, I can't do a northern accent. I haven't got a deep voice. Why don't you get a bloke from up north with a deep accent? He went, oh, yeah, OK. And I didn't get the job.
Oh, no.
What's the point of asking me to do a deep voice? Don't get me to do it, you div. Get somebody with a deep voice.
Should have got me in or Sean Bean.
Yeah, you. Yeah, you know, that's great.
So you couldn't do a high voice?
No, I can sometimes.
No, it doesn't sound to know.
No, it doesn't.
No. Joe's better. No.
I have rung up before my agent and pretended to be Joe. And she actually fell for it.
You have not.
Yeah, Deborah Willett, independent. I phoned her up, left a message as Joe Pasquale.
That's fantastic.
Yeah. Can you do it now? No. You said no even before I asked.
I had some helium.
When you do your voices as well, though, do you have to do regional accents?
Yes, sometimes, especially with games, sometimes you do around 250 lines an hour. You have to record, so they're really quick.
That's a lot.
They pop up, and you literally get the script as you go in, so you don't get to see the script at all. So sometimes they'll go, try Welsh, and they'll try it, and they'll go, actually, no, leave that. Let's move on.
So what's your best accent you can do?
I don't know. A northern is used a lot now in games and adverts as well. Used an awful lot. But mainly, I normally do just rough London. That's what they ask for a lot. Assassin's Creed I was on in the last two Assassin's Creeds and Witcher and this new game and Tintin. I've done loads of...
See, everybody will know your voice, but also know your face because, of course, you've been on so many things as well. You've been in... you were in The Bill as well, weren't you?
For a couple of long stints. That was lovely to do that. And I'm with a lovely actor, John Bowler, from The Bill. You'll know his face. And he's in WPC 56, playing one of the lead older characters, the more senior officers.
Give your show a big plug then. When can everybody see it?
Basically, it's on from Monday to Friday. The whole series plays in 1 week at 2:15 every day, which is normally an actor's nap time. So don't nap at 2:15. But of course, you can see it on iPlayer. It's a great show, and there's some great people in it. There's also another young, fantastic actor called Liam Jevons. He plays PC Perkins. He's going to be very big. And it's just a lovely show. And
you've got a lovely
really
smile on your face when you talk about it. You obviously are proud.
I honestly am, yeah. I had the best time. We all did. It was a great... And people are being asked to do shows now very quickly for less money and all that kind of stuff. And the cast and crew you get together is the same as if you were, you know, all being paid a fortune. Actually, it's just the people. That's what, you know, makes...
Isn't it wonderful that we all get paid to do... Not paid very much, but paid to do something that we love.
Oh, my God, yeah.
We're very lucky. Very lucky. Can you hang around to try another cocktail?
You
don't. Do you drink cocktails?
I'll have a non-alcoholic.
Okay, he'll do a non-alcoholic for you and for Joe Pasquale, because you never know what's going to happen if we give him any more.